What you're looking at now is one step in the direction of a future free of fossil fuels. Behind me here is a plug-in hybrid car which can be run purely on battery power. So that means you could travel to and from work or school without using one single drop of petrol. The person in the driver's seat of this eco-friendly automobile project is Josh Usher.
Now, Josh, apart from the fancy paint job, how is this car different to your average car?
Well, this is actually very similar to your average car. The only difference is that we've added an extra set of batteries, which add on to the car that's already there.
Well, hybrid cars have series batteries in them. What are the batteries in this car like?
The batteries in this car are actually similar to batteries in a hybrid car, except you can plug them into your home and charge them up from electricity. Now, what that means is that electricity can become your new primary source of power instead of petrol.
Okay, well, I'm pretty keen to see how it runs. Can we take it for a spin?
Sure, let's go.
Drive like a normal car, but it is a lot quieter.
Well, it is a normal car, but with the extra batteries, when it runs on electricity, it doesn't make any noise.
So odd not hearing an engine when you start it up.
Yeah, it takes a bit of getting used to.
And let's get down to the nitty-gritty facts. How fast can the car go and how far?
Well, because it's a normal car, it can go as fast as any car, and I'm sure it can go faster than the speed limit. In terms of distance, it goes about 30 to 40 kilometers on electricity, and then becomes a normal hybrid again. So at that point, it depends how much petrol you have in your tank. Now, that compares to about the 32 kilometers that the average commuter drives in Sydney. So a general commute, you could probably do on electricity.
These new batteries will be charged using green energy, which means you will drive around and remain carbon neutral. But Josh has one more trick up his environmentally sustainable sleeve.
We've added an inverter. So an inverter allows us to take some of the power out that we put into the car when we charge it using our plug in our garage or at our home. What's unique about that is just at the back here, we can just plug in something like a power board, and into that power board we can plug in lights, air conditioners, your television. And what that actually allows us to do in terms of the long run in this is to be able to put energy back into the electricity grid. So this gives utilities a whole new tool with which to control electricity. So these are basically big storage devices driving around, and we can utilize them by doing things like taking energy back out at times of peak demand when we really need that energy. Whereas the rest of the time we can just be driving around using the energy that's in the battery pack for our motion. So it's a pretty big development in plug-in hybrids.